Hi everyone, in this video we will discuss all the type B questions of the chapter Python Fundamentals from class 11. Now the first question is like this: from the following, find out which assignment statement will produce an error, state reason 2. So the first statement is like this: x is equal to 55 and here there is no error because this is a correct code. X is a variable name, or you can say the identifier, and which is assigned with a value 55. Now the second one, y is equal to 037. This is wrong. It's having some error. Why? Because this is a decimal value which should not begin with 0. So that is the reason. Now the next one is z is equal to 0098. So this is basically one octal integer representation. The literal is octal value, but as you know, octal numbers should not be more than 7. The maximum range is 7. So here the numbers are 9 and 8, so that is invalid. Next, 56th number is equal to 3300, which is again wrong. Why? Because an identifier name should not begin with a digit. Now length is equal to 450.17. Here there is no error. Now next, exclamation Taylor is equal to instant. Here you can say the identifier name should not begin with a special character, but since here it is beginning with a special character, so it is one invalid identifier. Now this variable is equal to 87.E02. So this, the literal is correct, but the variable name or the identifier is incorrect because it contains a space within it, which is not allowed. Next, float is equal to 0.17e-03. That is okay. The value is okay, but actually you are not supposed to give identifier name as a reserved keyword. Here float is a reserved keyword. So even though it will not give an error at runtime, but this is not a good practice. Now next, float in uppercase, that is assigned with some value, and here there is no error. Now find out the errors in the following code fragments. You can see here the first code is like this: temperature is equal to 30 and it is just displaying print temperature. So here there is an error because print is a function, so whatever value you have to pass, that you have to pass within parentheses. So you can just write the correct code like this: print within parenthesis, if you just write temperature, then it will display the temperature value as 30. Now the next code is like this: a is equal to 30, then b is equal to a plus b. So here it will give an error because b is not defined before, so there is no value for b. So this is an error. And next statement is print a and b. So here if it is trying to do and operation, then you have to write and in lower case, that is the keyword in lower case, that it will do and operation between a and b and it will give you the result. But since here and is written in upper case, here it will produce one more error. Now the next code is like this: abc is equal to 289. That means a is assigned with value 2, b is with 8 and c is with 9. Now it is printing abc. Now CBA is equal to ABC. That means C is assigned with the value A, B is assigned with the value B, and A is assigned with the value C. Now again it is printing ABC, but here this time instead of comma, it is given semicolon over here. So that is the error over here. That means you should avoid giving semicolon in between the identifiers. You can give comma separators. Now the next code is like this: x is equal to 24, that is fine. Now 4 is equal to x. Here you will get an error. Why? Because 4 is a literal value which is basically assigned in the RHS or the right hand side of the statement. This is a R value, so it cannot be there present in the left hand side of the assignment. So that is the error over here. Now the next one is print x is equal to x. Here you can see x is equal to is within the quotes. That means that is a string. The next x is a variable or the identifier, and they both should be separated by comma. So there is no comma given over here. That's the error. Now the next one is else is equal to 21 minus 5. Here it will give an error because you are using else as an identifier, whereas else is a preserved keyword, so you cannot use the keyword as an identifier. So that is the error. Now, what will be the output produced by the following code fragments? You can see first x is equal to 10. Now, x is equal to x plus 10. That means now x becomes 20. Now, again, x is equal to x minus 5. That means x now becomes 20 minus 5. That is 15. Now, it is printing x. Then you can see the output is 15. So, now the current value of x is 15. Again, x comma y is equal to x minus 2 comma 22. That means x is assigned with the value x minus 2. That is 15 minus 2, 13. And y is assigned with the value 22. So you can see the output like this. Print x, y, it will print 13 and 22. Now here you can see first is a variable which is assigned with the value 2. And second is a variable which is having value 3. And third is another variable which is assigned with the value first into second, that is 2 into 3. So third will have value 6. Now it is printing first comma second comma third, so it will print 2 comma 3 comma 2, 3 and 6 with space in between. Now first is equal to first plus second plus third. So first value, second value and third value will be added. First was having value 2, second is having value 3 and third is having value 6, so they will be added. Now first is having value 11. Now third is equal to second into first, that is second value is, as you know, that is 3 and first value is 11. So 3 into 11, that is 33. Now again, if you print first, second, third, then it will print the values as 11, 3 and 33. Now next code is like this. Side is a variable which is assigned with a value that will be given at the runtime. Okay, so that will be converted into int. Now area is calculated as side into side. Now it is printing sides and area. So first of all, once you run the program, it will ask for the side, and suppose the value given is 7. Now area will be calculated as side into side, that is 7 into 7, 49. So it is printing side comma area, that means it will print the value that you have given as side, that is 7, and the calculated area is 49 over here. Now what is the problem with the following code fragments? You can see the first code is like this. A is equal to 3, then print A. B is equal to 4, print B. S is equal to A plus B, print S. So here you can see before all the print statements, there is one indentation, which is not required before the print statement. So those are the errors over here. No indentation is required before print statement. The second one, there is a name variable which is assigned with a value Preshit and age is value 26. Now it is printing name and age are name plus age. Here plus is the concatenation operator. To concatenate, basically two strings, or you can say two integers that can add. But here one type is a string, your name is a string type of variable, and age is one integer type of data. So we cannot concatenate them together. So that will give an error. So you can just write print name and age are name comma age. That is the corrected code. That way you'll get the correct output. Now the next code is like this. A is equal to 3, S is equal to A plus 10. That means S is having value now 13. Now again, A is equal to new. That means we're assigning another value to the variable A. Here new is a string type of value. Now Q is equal to A by 10. So always it will access the latest value or the updated value. So here the latest value of A is new, which is a string. And we are trying to divide a string with one integer. So it's not possible. So that is why it will give error in that particular line. Now question number 5 and 6 both are like predict the output of the following codes. So we'll just check with the code of question number 5. It is like this. X is equal to 40 and Y is equal to X plus 1. That means Y is equal to 41. Now we are assigning X is equal to 20 comma Y plus X. So here you can notice that we are assigning two values to the variable x. First value is 20 and second value is y plus x, that is 41 plus 40, that is 81. So if you assign two values to the single variable, then it will be considered as a tuple object. That means more than one values are given to this variable. So automatically it will be considered as a tuple. So x will be assigned with the values 20 comma 81 in a form of a tuple. Now it is printing x comma y. So first it will print the value of x, that is 20 comma 81, in a form of a tuple. And next y value is 41. So that will be the output. Now next code is like this: x comma y is equal to 20 comma 60. That means x is having value 20 and y is having value 60. Now y comma x comma y is equal to x comma y minus 10 comma x plus 10. That means y is assigned with the value x initially. Just maintain the order. Okay. So first variable assigned with the first literal. So y is equal to x. That means first value of y is equal to 20 because x value is 20. Now x is equal to y minus 10. That means x is equal to y minus 10. So y value was 60. Before that you can see y was assigned the value 60. So 60 minus 10, that is 50. Now next y is equal to x plus 10. Okay, so now your x value was 20. So 20 plus 10, that is 30. So the latest value of y is 30. Now it will print x comma y. So x value was 50. You can see previously you have just assigned the value 50 to x. Now y value was 30. So it will display the last values or the latest values of x and y, that is 50 and 30. Now predict the output. You can see a comma b is equal to 12 comma 13. That means a is with value 12 and b is with value 13. Now c comma b is equal to a into 2 comma a by 2. That means c is with value a into 2 and b is equal to a divided by 2. So c becomes a into 2, that is 12 into 2, 24. And b becomes a divided by 2, that is 12 by 2, that is 6. Okay, so why you are doing all these problems? Why? Because it just wants to show that once you have assigned a value to a particular variable, then after that in the program, if you are changing the value, then it will always access the latest value or the last value or the updated value. It will not get or it will not access the previous value. The previous value will be overridden, you can say. So now your value of A will be 12 and value of B is equal to A by 2, that is 6, and value of C is 24. Now the next code is like this: a comma b is equal to 12 comma 13. That means a is with value 12 and b is with value 13. Okay, now it is just writing print within that, print within that a plus b. So first of all, it will execute the inner print statement and it will print 25. Okay, print of a plus b, that is it will print 25. Then the outer print statement will be executed. Okay, so the value for the outer print statement is the value which is returned by the inner print statement. You can say the inner print statement is not returning any value. Any of the print statement does not return anything. Print function does not return anything. That you will get more clear idea about it once you learn the functions. Okay, so before that, just let me tell you one thing. Print function does not have any return type. It does not return anything. So nothing means in like the terminology is none. None means nothing. So within that, like you can say the outer print statement is actually printing nothing. So it will display none as the output. Now predict the output. Here you can see ABC is equal to 10, 20 and 30. That means A is with value 10, B is with 20 and C is 30. Now PQR is equal to C minus 5 comma A plus 3 and B minus 4. That means the value of P is C minus 5, that is 30 minus 5, 25. Value of Q is A plus 3, that is 10 plus 3, 13. Value of R is equal to B minus 4, that is 20 minus 4, 16. So these are the values of P, Q, R. Now it is printing ABC colon ABC. That means the value of a comma b comma c is 10, 20, 30 respectively, then PQR values are 25, 13 and 16 respectively. And you can see the first print statement is having an end argument over there. That means by default, if you don't give any end argument, then by default, the next print statement will come in the next line. That means the new line character will be entered over there. But since here you have given a space as the value for the end argument, so the next print statement will be displayed in the same line. Now find the errors in following code fragments. You can see the first code is like this, y is equal to x plus 5, and it is printing x and y. Here it will give an error. Why? Because x value is not defined over here. Now the next one is like this, within print it is just written x is equal to y is equal to 5. So here basically this is an assignment statement which is given within the print statement. This is one invalid syntax for print statement. Now the next one is a is equal to input value. That means it will ask from the user to enter some value which will be taken in the form of a string. Now you are writing b is equal to a divided by 2, which will give you error. Why? Because a is having a string value and we cannot do any division operation on a string object. So that's how it will give you error. Now consider the code and find error if entered value is xi. You can see c is equal to int input, enter your class, and it is printing your class is c. Here you'll get an error because it is asking for one integer value, but xi is not an integer literal. This is a string value, so it will give some error. Now consider the code and suggest the solution to display the output in a single line. You can see the code is like this. Name is a variable which will store the name that will be entered by the user. Now it will print hi, comma, name, comma. After that, again it is printing how are you doing. But we want this to appear in a single line. So just use one end argument with a space in the first print statement. What will happen? By default, actually, if you don't give any end argument, by default, it will take the new line or the next line as the default value. But once you give an end statement with some other character, like here I have given space, then it will end with a space. The next line will appear after that space. So once you run the program, it will ask you for the name, then it will just print like this, hi, then the name, then comma, then it will enter a new line over there, rather it will just give a space over there, and the next line that has to be printed will be displayed in the same line, that is how are you doing. Now find errors in the following code fragment. You can say c is equal to input, enter your class. In print last year, you were in class, then C minus 1 is after the parenthesis. So here there are two errors you can see. First of all, C is the variable which should store a integer literal. Why? Because you are doing C minus 1 calculation over there. So you cannot accept a string value over there. You have to convert it into integer. So C is equal to int input, enter your class. And there you have to enter an integer value while running the program. Okay, let's say the value entered is 12. Then only the arithmetic calculation can be done on the variable C. Now it is printing last year you were in class, comma C minus 1. C minus 1 has to be given within the parenthesis. Okay, then you'll get the output like this, last year you were in class 11. Now what will be returned by Python as a result of following statements? The first statement is like print type of 0. So type is a function which will return you the data type of the value which you pass within the function. So here we are passing the value as 0, which is one integer value. So it will print class int. That means 0 is a integer type of data. Now it is now the next one is print type of int of 0. That means we are converting some value into integer. Obviously then the value will be integer itself, so the type will be same integer, class int. The next one is print type of int of 0, but here 0 is given within quotes. That means here 0 is considered as a string, but since it is again casted or converted into integer by using int function, So here the type will be int, same integer. Now next, print type of 0 within quotes. So here 0 is considered as a string, so your data type will be string. So it will display class str. That means here 0 is a string type of data. Now print type of 1.0. 1.0, as you can see, it contains a decimal point, so it is a float type of data. Now print type of int of 1.0. So here 1.0 is converted into integer, so its type will be int. Now next, print type float of 0. So you're converting 0 into float type of data, so its type will be float. Now next, print type float of 1.0. So here 1.0 is again converted into float type, and its data type will be float. Now print type of 3/2. So 3/2 will give you one decimal value, so the data type will be a float. Now what output will be produced by following code? The code is like this: str of print plus 1 within string. Okay. So here, first of all, the first print statement or the inner print statement will be executed. And since there is no value within the print function, so it will print nothing. That means the blank line will appear first. Then it will display none 1. You can see. Why? Because you can see the print function then plus added with or appended with a string called 1. The return type of this print statement is nothing. It doesn't return anything. And in Python, nothing is represented by none. Okay. So none appended with 1, that becomes none 1, which is again converted into string. That means first of all, the returned value of the print statement will be converted into string, that is none, which is appended with 1, will display none 1. Now the next one is like this: str of print within print hello plus 1. So here also the same thing. First of all, the inner print statement will be executed, and here you can see the print statement is having value hello, so hello will be printed. Now the next line, that is this print hello, will be converted into string. Okay, the print hello is not returning any value. That means what it returns is none. None plus appended with 1 will give you the value as none 1. Now what will be the output of the following code? You can see print within that print hola. So here the first, the inner print statement will be executed and it will display hola. Then the outer print statement will be executed and it will display none. Why? Because the value which is returned by the inner print statement, that will be passed as the value for the outer print statement. And the inner print statement does not return anything. As I told you, print function does not return any value, or you can see the returned value of any print statement is none. So none is passed as a statement for the outer print statement, so it will just display none in the second line. Now the same thing in the second case, you can see the same thing, but only one thing added, that is one end statement is given over here. End argument is there. So once the inner print statement will be executed, it will print hola, and the next line it has to print none, but since end argument is given over here, so it will print none in the same line itself. Now carefully look at the course, why is the last assignment gives error? As you know, all these variables A, B and C are storing some like octal numerals. You can see octal representation of the numbers. So first one is 0012, that is one octal value. B is storing 0013 and C is storing 0078. But here, as you know, octal representation should not have digits which are more than 7. But since here 8 is present, so that is going to give you error. Now what will be the output of the code? ABC is equal to 2, 3, 4. That means A is 2, B is 3 and C is 4. And ABC is equal to A into A, comma A into B, comma A into C. That means A is now A into A, that is 4. B is now A into B, that is 6. And C is now A into C, that is 8. So once you run, you'll get the output as 4, 6 and 8. Now the id function can be used to get the memory address of a variable. Consider the following code and tell if the following id functions will return the same result or not. So here you can see, first of all, the variable num is having value 13 and it is printing the id of num. Then num is equal to num plus 3, that means num value is now 16. Now again it is printing id of num. Then num is equal to num minus 3, that is 16 minus 3, that is 13. And again it is printing id of num. And now num is assigned with a new value hello, and it is printing id of num. So there are four print statements. And once you run this, you'll get that the first and third print will return the same memory address. Why? Because in these two cases, the variable num is pointing to the same value, that is 13. And the second and fourth print statement, they will return different memory addresses. Why? Because here num point to different values. So here you can see there are two sets of codes which are nearly identical, okay, along with the execution. You can see the first code fragment after taking input gives error, while the second one does not produce any error. So here you can see the first print statement is like this. Print within that num is equal to float of input value 1. That means it is taking some value as input from the user and is converted into float. It is assigned to a variable num, and the whole assignment we have passed within print statement. Okay. Now in the second case, you can see print within that float input value 1. That means here it will ask the user to enter a value which will be converted into float, and it will print the value. So what will happen in our first case, you can see within print statement we are doing one assignment. Num is equal to float input, that means the input value that will be given by the user, that is assigned to the variable num within print function. So which is a wrong thing, which is syntactically wrong. So we cannot assign any value to a variable within print function. This is a wrong statement. So that is how it will give you error for the first code. Whereas in a second code, we are just taking a value and it is printing that value which is entered by the user. There is no assignment is done over here. So that is absolutely fine. So second code will not give you any error. Now predict the output of the following code. And this is a very easy one. First of all, it is taking some values as input. For days, it is converted into integer and it is multiplied with 3600 and then with 24. So days value which is entered by the user, that will be multiplied with 3624. Again, hours value will be multiplied with 3600, and minutes value will be multiplied with 60, and seconds value will be just taken as it is. Now we are just adding all these values and printing the amount of seconds. So you can see once you run the program, you have to enter some values for the days. Let's say as for the question, you're entering the values 1. And second, you're entering some values for hours, that is 2. Then some values for minutes, that is 3. And some values for seconds, that is 4. So 1 day is converted into seconds. So 1 day is how many seconds? 1 into 24 into 3600, that many seconds. Then hours value entered is 2. So 2 hours is how many seconds? That is 3600 multiplied with it. That is the second value. Now the minutes entered is 3. That will be multiplied with 60 to give you the value in seconds. The seconds value is also taken and all are added to give you the time value in terms of seconds. Now here is the solutions of chapter 2, that is Python fundamentals, and here we had discussed all the type B questions. And if there is any doubt, you can put it in comment section, and stay tuned for more solutions and do subscribe. Thank you.